With the release of GPT-4o by OpenAI, we can now do even more. Now you can ask questions about not only text but also image through the API. This can be very interesting. Previously, we could only ask ChatGPT questions by text and get answers via text. Now you can provide information about an image here and receive a text reply. Let me show you how it works. Touching the screen to capture this image. Now it's transferred with the HTTP POST method through the ChatGPT library. And then you can receive a response from the OpenAI server. The question I entered in advance was summarize the contents of this book. This is very interesting. To answer my question, it needs to find a book from an image, figure out what the book is, and summarize and convey information about it to the user. We can easily find objects we want in images using models such as Yolo and Mobile Lab. If your goal is to find the object you want in an image, it's still great and works well. But I think this goes one step deeper, it's another level. It involves understanding the user's question and context and driving meaningful content about it. This is amazing. If we utilize this, it may be possible to create more interesting applications, especially in embedded environment where an internet connection is available. Other features of this GPT-4o are also excellent, but vision understanding is more excellent. This is just my point of view. While earlier versions had advanced capabilities, the new one shows a significant improvement in visual understanding, surpassing benchmarks of GPT-4t, Gemini, and Claude. This is a library created to easily use ChatGPT in the Arduino environment, and I made it. Sorry for not updating recently. It was created to perform very simple tasks and supports only text and image. If possible, I'd like to support passing audio data through this API if they support it. There are two ways to transfer images. One is to send an image link, and the other one is to encode the image data into Base64 and include it in the body of the HTTP post. There is an example so you can easily check it. Do you remember this project? This was a project created using ChatGPT when it first came out. The purpose of this project was to obtain information on how plants can grow well by providing soil data such as humidity and temperature to ChatGPT. Now by providing not only text information but also image information, I think we can ask more diverse questions to ChatGPT. If that really happens, I think we can create a process that can be more automated. Alright, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.